Welcome. Today we are going to tell you how to enjoy In Time. We saw it this weekend. Boy.
Now, if I may.
Go ahead.
I wasn't there for the inception and basically planning out what this podcast was going to be. But the idea is that every movie can be enjoyed. If you go in with the right expectations, right? You know? That's the idea behind the podcast?
Yeah. Yes.
Well, I think we found it. I think we found the movie that cannot be enjoyed.
We broke the podcast.
We broke the podcast. Actually, you know what? I lied. Here's how you enjoy In Time. Stay up for like 5 days straight, you know, caffeine, whatever it is, and bring a pillow to the theater and like just get a couple of seats, you know, and just sleep through the whole thing. That's how you can enjoy it. In Time.
I have a feeling I'm going to be pretty opposite from you guys on this episode, because I know how Max feels about it already. He couldn't not talk about it the other night. So
I'll tell you how to enjoy it. Just wait until it comes out free on Instant Watch, and watch it from the comfort of your home when you're doing something else like that takes a lot of attention.
Like anything.
And you can just look up every now and then, and just think. Well, that was a good movie.
Wait till it comes out on Instant Watch, and then like put your TV in the closet and shut the closet and lock the door and let it play.
It wasn't that bad.
All right.
That's how you can enjoy In Time.
All right. So obviously, I don't think it's difficult to say that this. I mean, this is not a great movie by any stretch of the imagination.
Yeah.
But were you guys really not entertained at all for the movie? Like, were you bored, or?
Like, the first 5 minutes, I was like, oh, cool idea. I wonder where we're going to go with this. And then it was like, the movie does not know what it wants to be. Does it want to be, like, a sci-fi movie? Does it want to be a heist movie? Does it want to be some kind of, like, political commentary?
That's, you know? Yeah. And I just thought the reason why I had a hard time enjoying it is because there were so many ways it could have gone. And it, like, starts going a certain way, like, oh, they're going to be robbers and go on a... And they like rob one place for time and give out time, and then you're like, oh, they're gonna bring down this Pete Campbell guy, who's the girl's dad, and they didn't really bring him down. I mean, I don't know. I agree with Matt. Like, he didn't know where it was wanting to go. But
first time, like, everybody in the movie is 25 years old, so like you're supposed to. I don't know. That's the first time that like when he walks in and his mom is there and his mom is 25 and he's like. Hey, Mom. And she's like, I love you, son. But they're both 25.
Yeah.
That's the first hint that I was like, oh, man.
I thought that was cool.
Okay, well.
Well, I mean, okay, so for me, the idea of the movie was enough for me to enjoy it all the way through. If only just so that I could sit there watching what's on the screen while thinking about all the cool stuff that they're not telling us about, or how, you know, how this came to be, how that came to be, how this works, you know, all that kind of, like, it was fun for me to think about all the stuff that the writers were too lazy to either tell us or...
It's too deep or...
Yeah, like, it is very lazily written. It could have obviously been a lot better, but ultimately I was entertained throughout the whole time. I wasn't bored. And like I said, I had a good time just kind of thinking about the concepts behind the movie.
Yeah, thinking about it is cool. Like, you have a running clock on your arm and that's kind of your payment. If you want a cup of coffee, it's like 4 minutes. But I just kept thinking.
Yeah, and who in the ghetto would buy a cup of coffee for 4 minutes? When they live in 24 hours at a time, you know? Like,
yeah, and I just kept thinking, man, if we lived in that society, I would not be in this movie. I'd be like, oh my god, 2 hours! I could have bought 12 cups of coffee or whatever.
But I think that's kind of what they're trying to say, is that people spend like, you know, $5 on coffee every morning, even though it's only $5, but, you know...
Yeah, but they don't have $30 left to their name, where they're gonna die if they lose that $30. It's a little different.
That's true. People in the ghetto don't do that, I guess. The whole thing was silly. They couldn't decide what they wanted to do, so instead of sticking like with one path, like if they had left all the sci-fi stuff kind of in the background and made it a heist movie, I could see how that would
have been really cool, because it would have been like, they would have been stealing, but also you'd have the, you know...
Like, here's this sci-fi background, but we're not going to go too deeply into that. This is going to be a cool heist movie.
Yeah, yeah, that would have been cool, and I liked that part when they started. I thought they were going
to
start...
Were like, well, we have to explain every single logical rule, and instead of showing that stuff, they told it to you. Like, they told you exactly what was going on. Like, okay, if Justin Timberlake grew up in this world, there's no reason why he would have to ask people questions about... You know, like, they wouldn't have to have as much exposition. The rules of this world.
And the fighting was stupid and way bigger part of the movie than it should have been.
Oh, I keep forgetting about that. Yeah, they have their time on there. They can transfer time by holding each other's wrist.
Like, it was
demonstrate. And they'd be like, I'd be taking Ryan's time, then he takes my time. It was totally stupid.
The strategy is that you go down to close to zero so it distracts your opponent. Like,
I forgot about that. Yeah, that was bad.
Just so dumb. And it breaks my heart, too, because I like almost all of the actors in it, you know?
And it's just such a great idea.
Yeah.
I like Timberlake. I like Cillian Murphy. I like Pete Campbell, Vincent Kartheiser, or something like that. I don't know.
Cillian Murphy was awesome in it.
Yeah, I liked his character a lot.
He's a good character. He's really good in it.
Yeah, and then they tried to do so many time puns that were just ridiculous.
Oh, I know. And they throw them at you in bursts.
Yeah. And, like, the way it was written, they tried to make it so that, like, every single line was cool. Like, another movie that did that was Terminator 4, Terminator Salvation. They tried to make every single line cool so that nothing felt organic. Like, these people, nobody would talk like that.
Yeah.
The whole thing. So, yeah, if you want to enjoy this movie, wait till it comes out on DVD.
Ooh. Buy the light.
DVD.
He lost the light. Don't worry about it.
Light just fell.
That's all right.
Here's what you want to do. You want to buy the DVD and then lose it on the bus on your way home. That's the way you can enjoy
time.
Well, okay. I think go with a couple friends and look forward to the after movie discussion of, you know, the cool things like discussing how certain stuff works with paying with time and, you know, maybe how it all originated, you know, how it came to be. I mean, there's some cool discussion that can happen after the movie. Just because it is such a cool idea.
Yeah, I think maybe that's why, like, I'm being so harsh, is because, obviously, you see, you know, like, Shark Knight 3D or whatever, and you know it's going to be terrible.
Yeah.
But this movie, I actually had high expectations for, and so then it's just a huger disappointment.
Yeah, so just know it's not going to be that good. But
it's tough when you go see movies that have huge potential. And,
yeah.
I mean, they can be, you know... It's not difficult for them to be very disappointing because of the huge potential. So.
Yeah.
All right, let's do a better or worse. I just picked some technology-based future sci-fi type movies.
Okay.
Surrogates?
Worse.
Way worse.
Worse, yeah.
We're going to say worse on all of these.
Well, I tried to pick ones that may be kind of questionable, but possibly not. Transformers 3, I know not really technology-based, it's their life forms, but...
How do you think they built robots?
I mean, that's debatable, but it's mostly technology. I mean, really...
Well, they're aliens, they're not technology, is it? Anyways, go on.
It's alien technology, Ryan, I don't understand what the...
Would you call humans human technology?
Yeah.
You would?
Yeah, if rabbits invented something, I'd be like, oh, that's rabbit technology.
Yeah, trillions of years of evolution.
No, but they're not invented, those are the aliens. They aren't invented by aliens and then sent to Earth, those are the aliens.
Yeah, but the aliens are mechanical in nature.
They're aliens because they're from another planet. They're not aliens because they're organically grown. Somebody built the Transformers.
Yeah, the AllSpark.
You think somebody built the Transformers?
Yeah.
Is that a fact, or are you just assuming that?
Somebody designed them. It's common sense. All right, comment.
All right, it's a debate for another time. This is a debate for another time.
The Transformers just came to be.
They were created by the AllSpark.
Is it
evolved from lesser machines like iPod Nanos?
All right, is it better or worse, Transformers 3? I don't know if you answered it.
I don't know.
I thought it was better in Transformers 3. Hot tub time machine.
That's technology for you. Okay, how about like Minority Report? There's a movie where it's like
worse
technology.
Yeah, but Minority Report is easy, because it's a good movie. That's an easy movie to say better or worse. I tried to pick movies that were maybe questionable.
Debatable. I know I'm in the minority here, but I didn't like it.
All right, Tron Legacy.
Worse.
Didn't see it.
I didn't see it either.
Okay. All right.
Alright, I think that's it. Thanks for... Matt, do you want to tease our special coming up at the end of the... or next week?
Yeah, stay tuned for... we're going to be talking about just movie settings that would suck to live in. And this isn't just specific characters. Like, obviously you can pick a character and be like, well, that would suck to go through that. But I mean, like, a normal person in the world, it would just suck. So look forward to that. Also, I want to see comments. Comments on this video. Were Transformers built or just... they just appeared one day?
What do you...
I'd like to see the internet chime in on this one. So Ryan knows how dummy. Sorry. I'm such a jerk for that.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching.